Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. Welcome to a new video. Today I will be addressing a video made by AP on the topic of the Christchurch Mosque shooting, which he named the Christchurch Mosque Massacre Blame Game. But before I actually get into the video, I would like to say this. What I'm going to do today is not point the finger at Ridwan, nor am I going to blame him for these attacks. That would be utterly ridiculous. However, what I'm going to look at is whether the assertion that this attack was Islamophobic or not is true or false. Other than that, before I start, I would also like to add that Ridwan did condemn the attacks. He did the commonsensical human thing to do. So I would like that everyone approaches this video as maturely as possible. So let's get right into it. So for those of you who do not know, the Christchurch Mosque shooting happened on the 15th of March 2019, roughly 5 months ago from the point of making this video. The attacks were carried out by a person called Brenton Tarrant, who was an alt-right fascist. He essentially carried out an attack on the An-Nur Mosque and the Islamic Linwood Center Mosque, which resulted into the vile murder of 51 Muslim men, women and children and the injury of 40 Muslim men, women and children. He was thereafter quickly arrested and caught by the police, charged for murder, and now he awaits his trial in May 2020. The initial reaction of the New Zealand citizens and politicians was naturally utter shock and devastation. The community was busy helping the families of the victims who fell, and the Prime Minister of New Zealand, Jacinda Ardern herself, refused to even say the name of the individual that committed this act. Now, if we actually go back to the video that AP made, he focuses mostly on what Brenton Tarrant wrote in his manifesto prior to carrying out the attacks. The manifesto is called The Great Replacement, named after a concept of the white genocide. In other words, the concept that white people are being passively killed by immigrants joining Europe and having high fertility rates. AP throughout the video makes arguments based on the statements that Brenton Tarrant himself makes. So let's look at some of those.
But there has been a lot of finger pointing, a lot of talk, mostly clueless talk, about this whole tragedy. And these talks have mostly included ignorance, ill intent, or hypocrisy. Let us make a few things clear first. One of the most widely circulated and believed things is that Islamophobic, anti-Islamic or anti-Muslim speech fueled this attack and was responsible for it. That this is an act of Islamophobic, anti-Muslim xenophobia. People then went on accusing regular critics of Islam and Muslims. I have even been asked if I was now happy about this attack. This issue usually comes from not thinking the whole thing through, or being emotional and biased. The killer released a manifesto, in which he made all his thoughts and intentions clear. Of course, the mainstream media, politicians, and many others have either ignored this manifesto, never read it, cherry-picked it, or selected specific parts of the manifesto with political bias. To get the whole Islamophobia thing out of the way, this was not an act and example of Islamophobia and anti-Muslim sentiments and hate speech in this regard. If we simply look at the manifesto, we see that the terrorists didn't have anything against Islam as a religion, or against Muslims as a religious group and what they believe in. He says that he doesn't even dislike Muslims who live in their own lands. In another part of his manifesto, he also says that he visited different cultures and liked interacting with them and liked their hospitality. We even have recently circulated pictures and blog posts of him visiting countries like Pakistan or Turkey. People are also trying to connect that to some conspiracy theory, by the way, but that's again an ignorance of the manifesto. In there, he admits the visiting of those countries and cultures and liking them. He goes on further, saying that he only dislikes Muslims who choose to, quote, invade our lands, live on our soil, and replace our people. Yes, I dislike them. He also adds that the only Muslims he hates are Europeans who convert to Islam, because he sees them as traitors to the European heritage and culture.
Let's take a look at the first paragraph that AP quotes in his video from Tarrant's manifesto. Tarrant asks himself the question, did you or do you personally hate Muslims? He divides Muslims into three categories. Muslim people who live outside of his homeland with whom he is fine, apparently. And Muslim women and men that live inside of his land or on his soil. He views them as invaders and dislikes them. But in particular, he has a hatred towards Muslim converts, people that convert to Islam that are Europeans or Westerners. He thinks that they are blood traitors of his own race. So the interesting thing that you have to notice here is that he has a type of hatred towards Muslims, regardless of AP's contention on on Brenton Tarrant's racist views. The fact is, he expressed a type of hatred towards Muslims, converts, and that is a type of Islamophobia. In fact, that increases on Islamophobia because he doesn't even care about his own people. If they accept Islam, it's a good enough reason to hate them. So the Islamophobia there is really manifest and clear. And the definition of Islamophobia is any type of fear or hatred or prejudice against Muslims or Islam as a religion.
So why did he attack Muslims inside a mosque? He answers that question too in his manifesto. They were an obvious, visible, and large group of invaders from a culture with higher fertility rates, higher social trust, and strong, robust traditions that seek to occupy my people's lands and ethnically replace my own people. The shooter's problem was not what Islam is and what Muslims believe and represent. He describes himself as an ethno-nationalist, a nationalist based on common heritage, faith, and ancestry. An eco-fascist, someone who wants to protect the environment and the country's resources in order to defend the country's ethnic people through a totalitarian system. And a racist, insofar that his idea of keeping the West white and fighting all non-European immigrants is racist. I know many people use the word racist as an accusation, but that's only our point of view. Others gladly accept the term for themselves. The most dominant themes of his manifesto are white genocide and birth rates. He believes that a white genocide is going on, that white people are dying, and that other groups with higher fertility rates are replacing white people. And he thinks the solution to that is to kill people and maniacally start a race war. This is an ideology that is held very, very rarely within society, and even then, much rarely violent. It has nothing to do with Islam and Muslims, only with the fact that Muslims are non-Europeans. He also admits that he first targeted Muslims because they have been responsible for terrorist acts and historical fights with Europe, and says that targeting Muslims first would give his cause more attention, something he has achieved now, and that other groups would follow. If we called this attack Islamophobic now, and the terrorist got away, and attacked Indians next, then black people, then Asians, and added group-specific slogans to each one of them, would we also say, oh, he hates Indians, this is Indophobia. Oh, now he hates black people, typical white guy. Oh, he hates Jews, this is an anti-Semitic Nazi. Oh, he hates Asians, how does that happen? See, it doesn't make sense. That's why it doesn't make sense calling this an anti-Muslim or anti-Islamic sentiment. This is simply misleading and leads us away from the fact that this is a wider scheme of a crazy race war.
Now, the interesting thing is, during the video, AP will claim that media outlets cherry-picked the manifesto itself. But I would actually like to argue that the one who's doing the cherry-picking is only AP himself. Because there are two quotes that he did not mention that pertain to Islam and Islamophobia explicitly made by Brenton Tarrant. So let's take a look at these two. In this paragraph, the terrorist asks himself the question, were you or are you an Islamophobe? He answers with, no, I'm not afraid of Islam, only that due to its high fertility rates, it will grow to replace other peoples and faiths. So what the terrorist views as a type of Islamophobia is simply fear of Muslims. But this is the type of fallacious reasoning that a person who hates gay people, who wants to murder gay people, could use and say, no, I'm not a homophobe, I'm not afraid of gay people. This is simply what you call the etymological fallacy, deriving the old meaning of the word phobia, which means fear, and applying it to the new meaning, which is used in these labels, Islamophobia and homophobia and etc., that means a type of hatred and prejudice towards X group. Regardless if you fear or do not fear gay people, if you wish to murder them, you are a homophobe. If you wish to murder Jews or otherize them. You are an anti-Semite. It's not about fear. It's simply about hatred and prejudice. Now here comes the essential and crucial part to this discussion. The terrorists' own commentary on whether the attack was Islamophobic in origin or not. He says, Islamic nations in particular have high birth rates, regardless of race or ethnicity. So here he makes it clear that this has nothing to do with the race and ethnicity of people. It has to do with Islamic nations. And what else? He says, and in this there was an anti-Islamic motivation to the attacks. And to make matters worse for AP, what else does he say? He says, as well as a want for revenge against Islam for the 1,300 years of war and devastation that it has brought upon the people of the West and other peoples of the world. Let's put this into context. Tarrant here makes it clear, crystal clear to any intelligent person, that this attack had an element of hatred towards Muslims. It has nothing to do with race or ethnicity. Muslims, to him, are a threat due to what he says is a justified reason as high fertility rates. Don't buy into this. In fact, if we want to play with this kind of rhetoric, that his only reason for attacking Muslims is high fertility rates, is the same as us supporting neo-fascism. Because this person himself, later on in the manifesto, identifies as a neo-fascist. So it would be equal to saying, oh, fascists are not anti-Semites anymore. They just hate Jewish people. You know, this attacker was not Islamophobic. He just hates Muslims and thinks with his deluded mind, based on historical information that he pulled from probably 8chan due to his affiliation with those websites that are, by the way, alt-right dark web forums that spread misinformation and spread articles on rape, on direct threats and child pornography. This is the kind of ideology that inspired Tarrant. This is the kind of stuff that he watched to induce himself with hatred towards Muslims. He misinformed himself on history and used every type of cherry picking that he could and made up a justifiable reason called high fertility rates to make an attack on innocent people in a mosque that were praying to God. You really expect us, on these unfounded, unacademic reasons, to justify saying that this attack was not Islamophobic? I think that any intelligent person will see that this attack was clearly hatred towards Muslims, hatred towards other people. Wa alaikum assalam.